Dear learners, today we are going to learn about the constitutional values of our constitution and the political system working in India. Every country has its own constitution and its own political system. For example, you must have heard about the President of USA, but not of the Prime Minister of USA. Whereas in India, we almost hear about Prime Minister and President for India both. There is a basic difference between the political system of USA and the political system of India. There is no provision for the Prime Minister in USA. Both USA and India, although are democratic system of governance, but the structure of the government is different in both these countries. Same is true for every other country. Government of a country is run as per the provision of the constitution of that country. In other words, we can say that provisions of the constitution are the basic and fundamental rules and laws by which a country is governed. Let's learn about our own constitution, that is the Constitution of India. As you all know, that after getting independence on 15th of August 1947, the government of independent India could not be run on the same pattern as it was being run during the British government. We were in need of our own constitution, a new system of governance, our own rules and our own laws. Keeping this in mind, the leaders of the freedom movement and also the British government had anticipated the need of a new constitution for a newly independent country. Hence, to achieve this objective, a constituent assembly was constituted, which was to prepare the constitution for India. But before going ahead, we must know as to what does a constitution mean, what is the meaning of a constitution, and what does purpose do it serve. Constitution is a set of fundamental principles, basic rules and established precedents to run and regulate the various parts and aspects of the state and its structure. You should be very clear about constitution of any country. Constitution actually contains the fundamental rules and the laws by which government of that country works. It means it is the rules and laws of the governance. It also contains the powers and the functions of the major institutions under three organs of the government, and these are the legislature, the executive and the judiciary. The work of legislature is to frame and make laws for the country, for the nation, for the state, and the work of the executive is to implement those laws which have been framed by the legislature, and the work of judiciary is to test all those laws whether they are as per the constitution of that country or not. If those laws are not as per the constitution of the country, then judiciary can make all those laws and declare all those laws are null and void. Constitution also provides for the rights and freedoms of the citizens and defines the relations between the individual and the government. So, to frame new rules, new laws, new provisions of the constitution, the Constituent Assembly started its work to prepare the Constitution of India on 9th of December 1946, even before the independence. Dr. Rajendra Prasad was elected the President of Constituent Assembly on 11th December 1946, and Dr. B.R. Ambedkar was elected the Chairman of the Drafting Committee, which was to draft the Constitution of India. These two, as the Chairman of the Drafting Committee and President of the Constituent Assembly. Other members were from the fraternity which were deeply involved in the freedom struggle. Some of them were elected representatives of the assemblies and also the persons of experience. Most of the members of the Constituent Assembly were deeply involved in the freedom struggle. Some of them were elected representatives of assemblies and also the renowned experts of law and constitutions. These members of the Constituent Assembly met for 166 days and after a great deliberation and discussion on the various provisions of the Constitution, it was finalized and adopted by the Constituent Assembly on 26th November 1949. It took 2 years, 11 months and 18 days for the making and completing of the Constitution of India. And this Constitution was formally implemented on 26 January 1950, which is regularly celebrated as Republic Day every year. Because of the importance of 26th January on the day when we were Purna Swaraj demand was made by Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. So, to mark 26th January as a memorable day, 26th January has been chosen as a day on which Republic Day is celebrated. Our Constitution is a written and lengthy document which defines all the aspects of Indian political system. It has provisions regarding the territories that India will comprise, citizenship, fundamental rights, directive principles, fundamental duties, the structure and functions of the union, state and local level. Hence, it became a very lengthy document. It should be very correct to say that if you make an effort to go to some library and look at the Constitution of India, then you can have a feel how voluminous is the Constitution of India. Our Constitution has a preamble at the start of the Constitution and it describes the fundamental values and the philosophy on which the Constitution is based. These values and the process of Constitution making was influenced by many factors and few of them are following. Number one, aspirations of the people. You know, when we were in the freedom movement, we were facing many difficulties and aspirations of the people generated during that freedom struggle were having influence on the constitution makers. Secondly, the constitution and political changes that took place during the British rule. Thirdly, the Gandhian philosophy, because Gandhi was the leader who was leading the whole movement. So, his ideas and thoughts also influenced the constitution makers. Fourth, the socio-culture ethos of the country, that is India. And fifth, experiences of the functioning of the constitutions in different other democratic countries. Our constitution has accepted certain ideals, which were the aspirations of the people to have the kind of a country to live in. These ideas are known as the constitutional values. The first one is sovereignty. It means that our country has complete political freedom and is the supreme authority to take its own decision. We don't have any external pressure and nobody is there to challenge the authority of India. The sovereignty of the India lies in the people of India. It means that all the organs of the government, again legislature, executive and judiciary, draw their authority and power from the people of India. Second, what that comes there in the preamble of the Constitution of India is socialism. It is a value which aims to promote social change and transformation to end all form of inequalities. Social and economic inequalities have been inherent in our society. Socialism aims to end the concentration of wealth and power in the hands of few and to ensure social development of all and of all in all the fields. Then third comes secularism. Our country, as you know, is home to all the major religions of the world. We have diversity and plurality. In this context, socialism is a great constitutional value where we have no official religion. Our constitution is not against any religion, but we ensure that no discrimination is made on the basis of religion. Everybody is allowed to profess, preach and practice any religion of his or her choice. Secularism expects everyone to respect the religion of the others and not to denounce any other religion. Fourth value which comes and which can be seen in the preamble of Constitution of India is democracy. In India, all the organs of the government derive their authority from the will of the people. India is the largest democracy of the world, where all the citizens enjoy their freedoms and rights. People elect their government and can change the same after a fixed period of time. The universal adult franchise has ensured one man, one vote, and one value. Democracy allows everybody to have his or her own opinion and freedom to express his or her own viewpoint. A citizen can criticize the government and may make any demand from the government, because democracy is based on the rule of law, right of citizens, independence of judiciary, free and fair elections, and freedom of press. These are the basic principles on which the democracy of a country. Then comes republic. What is republic? Republic is that country where the head of the state is elected by the people. Any citizen can aspire for this office and has the right to contest as per the political equality. In India, no one can be head of the state on the basis of heredity. Here, head of the state is elected one and don't comes because of any kinship. Then comes justice. The constitution makers have included the social, economic, and political justice as the constitutional value. A democratic system is not a guarantee to the justice, but in our constitution, constitution makers have stressed that political freedom granted to the citizens should be instrumental in the creation of a new order which should be based on socio-economic justice. Just society is the foremost value of our constitution. Liberty is another value. The preamble prescribes liberty of thought, liberty of expression, liberty of belief, faith, and worship as one of the core values. Democracy cannot be experienced without the freedom of expression. Some minimum rights should be ensured to the citizen so that they may be able to enjoy the democracy and rule of the law. Eighth value which can be counted as is equality. Equality in our constitution means equality of status and equality of opportunities. Equal rights, equal treatment, and no discrimination before the law of the land. It is a significant value which gives respect and dignity to each and every citizen. Every citizen has a social, economic, and political rights without any discrimination. Fraternity, it means common brotherhood. We in India have a plural society which is full of diversity. Freedom, equality, and justice lead to a society where people have the feeling of belongingness and brotherhood. It seeks to abolish the untouchability and discrimination. It seeks to work together, and it seeks that every citizen should celebrate and should join the festivals of the other communities and have equal access to the public places and work for unity and integrity of the nation. Dignity of the individual, this is another value. Promotion of fraternity leads to dignity of the individuals. It also ensures equal participation of the people in all the process of democratic governance. Without dignity of the individuals, the people do not have the self-respect and self-confidence and self-esteem. Hence, to realize the value of democracy, dignity of the individual must be ensured. Then comes international peace and just international orders. The directive principles of the state policy, as included in the Constitution of India, direct the state A to promote international peace and security, B to maintain just and honorable relations between the nations, C to foster respect for international laws and treaty obligations, D to encourage settlement of international disputes by arbitration. So, these four points direct the state to have international peace and security and should frame such laws and policies that international peace and unity is established. All these acts combined together lead to the development of India and also ensure peace and security of the citizens of India. Then comes fundamental duties. Our constitution prescribes some duties to be performed by each and every citizen. Although these duties are not enforceable, yet these duties are very important for each and everyone to perform. Without duties, we cannot think of rights. The fundamental duties included in the constitution reflect the basic values like patriotism, nationalism, humanism, environmentalism, harmonious living, gender equality, scientific temper, inquiry, and individual and collective excellence. After learning the constitutional values of the Constitution of India, let's identify the main features of our Constitution. You know, our Constitution is a very lengthy document. It is written also. It has many unique features which other constitutions do not have. To start with, we identify some of the following important features. The first one is our constitution is a written constitution. Constitution of India is the longest written constitution, which contains 395 articles in 22 parts, 12 schedules and 5 appendices. Our constitution expresses the vision of India. It also specifies the rights and duties of the citizens. Second feature is our constitution is a unique blend of rigidity and flexibility. Generally, it is believed that written constitutions are rigid, which cannot be easily changed. But our constitution has a special procedure which has been laid down to make constitutional amendments, to make constitutional changes. Even this process of making amendments takes care of the federal structure of the government. There are 3 ways of making amendments which are in accordance with the importance of the change likely to be made. Some provisions of the constitution can be amended just by simple majority of Lok Sabha and Raj Sabha. Some other amendments need the special majority of the parliament, which should be 2/3 of the present and more than half of the total strength of the members of each house. And some other amendments need the approval of the majority of the states, that is more than half of the Indian states. Then third feature, fundamental rights and fundamental duties. The constitution guarantees the rights to the individuals against the state as well as against other individuals. These rights are justiciable, and anyone can knock at the door of the Supreme Court if his or her right is being violated or denied. Similarly, fundamental duties have also been included, but these duties are not enforceable. It is expected that being a responsible citizen of India, everyone should obey and follow the fundamental duties, because the duties are to show our love and respect to our nation and our constitution. Fourth feature is there is chapter on directive principles of state policy. Our state is a welfare state which strives for the welfare of the people. The constitution makers have included these principles to ensure social and economic freedom and also to ensure social justice. These principles are not justiciable, but are guiding force for the government to make the state a welfare state, to reduce inequalities and to spread the education. Directive principles are positive in character and are must for good governance. Then comes another feature, which is integrated judicial system. Our judicial system is an integrated judicial system, which is altogether different from judicial systems of many other countries. Although there is a Supreme Court at the national level, high courts at the state level, and subordinate courts at the district level, yet there is a single hierarchy of the courts. The aim of unified judicial system is to provide justice to each and every citizen in a uniform manner. Constitutional provisions of the Indian Constitution ensure the independence of the Indian judiciary, which is free from the influence of legislature and executive. Both cannot interfere in the process of judiciary. Then comes single citizenship. Indian Constitution has provision for single citizenship to its citizens. Unlike USA, where citizens have double citizenship, or dual citizenship of state and United States of America. In India, all the citizens of India are only Indians. One may reside in any part of the state, in any part of the country, but the citizenship will be only of India and not of the province or the state where he or she is living. This is also a unique feature which is different from the other federal states. Universal adult franchise. Here it describes that every citizen after attaining the age of 18 and above is entitled to vote and has a right to vote. There can be no discrimination on this right on the basis of caste, sex, religion, education or any other factor. This provision reflects the values of equality and justice, which is a guiding force of our constitution. Federal system and parliamentary form of government is another important feature. Our constitution has accepted federal system of governance, where all the 29 states have their own legislative bodies and can make laws for their own territories. This structure reflects the value of unity and integrity of the nation, along with decentralization of powers. The union has different set of powers and the states have a different set of powers. There is no confrontation between the two. Both rule the same people and both work for the welfare of the same people. The parliamentary form of government in India makes the executive answerable and responsible to the legislature. It also reflects the values of responsibility and sovereignty. Thus, we see that India has a federal structure, but the Constitution of India ensures a holding together federation which is working successfully for the last 6 to 7 decades. There is no doubt that the constitution makers included many a good provisions of other constitutions to make it unique and suitable for the Indian people. Let's revise the salient features of our constitution. First, it is the longest written constitution. It is a unique blend of rigidity and flexibility. Third, fundamental rights and fundamental duties have been included in the constitution. Fourth, India has been established as a welfare state and directive principles of state policy have been included in the constitution to achieve this aim of welfare state. Fifth, our constitution provides for a single integrated judicial system for the whole country. Sixth, there is no provision for dual citizenship and every citizen has only one or single citizenship and that is Indian. Seventh, every adult citizen of India has the right to vote. One man, one vote, one value is the provision which ensures equality and justice. Eighth, Indian constitution provides for a federal system of state along with parliamentary form of government. As we have learnt about the various features of the Indian constitution and found that the federal character of Indian constitution is different from the federal character of USA. It should be noted that generally there are two types of states in the world. The state which have only one government for the whole country is known as the unitary state. For example, the United Kingdom has this unitary form of government. There is one government for the whole of United Kingdom, but the states like USA and Canada have governments at two levels, one at the central level and another at the state level. It is accepted universally that any state having governments at two or more levels is a federal state and shall have some other important features. It should have a written constitution, division of powers between the central and the state governments, and supremacy of the judiciary to interpret the constitution. Federal states do have all these features, and same is true for India, because we are also having all these features in our constitution. Although the constitution of India has all these features, but with a little difference. Hence, the nature of Indian federalism is different from the nature of federalism in USA or any other such country. let's learn about the characteristics feature of the Indian federal system. We have learned so far about the constitutional values, the features of the constitution, and now the features of the federal system of which is working in India. India has two-tier system. The Constitution of India provides for a union government at the central level and a separate state government for each unit at the state level. At present, a new third level of government has been added by 73rd and 74th Amendment, which makes local self-government as the government and the state government as the third level of government. Central government and the state governments have separate list of subjects on which each can legislate to make laws. These lists have been given in the Constitution of India. Division of powers is another feature of our federal system. As told earlier, the Constitution of India has three lists. One is union list, which consists of 97 subjects of national importance, and only the union government can legislate on these subjects to make laws. These laws are for the whole nation. There is a second list in the Constitution, and that list is known as the state list, which has 66 subjects on which laws can be made by the state legislature. Every state can make different laws on the same subject. This freedom has been ensured by the Constitution of India. There is a third list called the concurrent list, on which laws can be made both by the union government and the state government, but in case of any confrontation between the two and the law made by the union government and the state government, then in case of confrontation, the law made by the union government will prevail. All other subjects which have not found place in these three lists come under the purview of the union government, and union government can make laws on such subjects. Third feature of the federal system of governance in India is to have a written and rigid constitution. Our constitution is written, rigid, and the longest one. Frequent changes cannot be made in our constitution, so it can be called a rigid constitution. Fourth parameter of the federal state is having an independent judiciary. Yes, in India, we have independent judiciary with Supreme Court at the apex. Supreme Court is the sole interpreter of the constitution and can declare any law null and void if found against the provisions of the constitution. On the basis of these characteristics, we find that Indian system has all the features of federalism, but still it is different from other federal states. Indian federal system pleads for a strong union government. Most of the time it is said that India is a federal in form, but unitary in spirit. This fact can be proved through various provisions of the constitution. The first article of the constitution states India to be union of states. Nowhere does the constitution of India describes India as a federal state. Union government can make and create new states and can also change the territory of any one state. This one feature indicates about the unitary spirit of the constitution. Secondly, division of power is also in favor of union central government. Most subjects, more power, residue power indicates the union government to be powerful. Thirdly, the federal principle envisage a dual system of court, but in India we have a unified integrated judiciary. Fourthly, the union government becomes very powerful when any one kind of emergency is proclaimed. All the powers come in the hands of the central government. Fifthly, the head of any state government, which is governor, is appointed by the union government. Sixthly, union government has very wide and effective financial powers and responsibilities. In the last, but not the least, is the supremacy of the executive powers of the central to give instructions to state government. All India services, the district admission of every district is headed by an IAS officer. All these facts show that our constitution is federal in nature, but unitary in spirit. So, through this, we have learnt about the constitutional values, of the Constitution of India. We have gone through the features of the Constitution of India, salient features of the Constitution of India, and also the features of the federal system working in India. Thank you.